published 17:14 Eastern Standard Time, the 19th of February 2018, updated 7:24 Eastern Standard Time, the 20th of February 2018. Sergio Aguero was punched and spat at during violent scenes in a mass pitch invasion after Manchester City's shock FA Cup defeat at Wigan on Monday night. One fan attempted to punch the Manchester City striker at full time and Aguero brushed him away before Wigan defender Cheyenne Dunkley, City coach Mikel Arteta and physiotherapist Stephen Lilley rushed to the Argentine's aid. Aguero followed the fan and Lilley pulled the forward away before he could retaliate. The City striker also appeared to be spat at. Sportsmail understands City will seek answers from Wigan about how an invasion was allowed to happen, putting their players in danger. The Football Association, meanwhile, is investigating four separate incidents from the match, including Aguero's confrontation with the supporter. Manchester City's Sergio Aguero reacts with fury and is held back by club physio Stephen Lilley after he was attacked by a supporter amid a mass pitch invasion after Wigan's 1-0 victory over the Premier League leaders. City striker Aguero was surrounded by supporters as he tried to leave the pitch after the final whistle on Monday. Wigan defender Cheyenne Dunkley, right, can be seen approaching to try and break up the confrontation. Aguero appeared to lash out a supporter following City's shock FA Cup defeat at the hands of Wigan. A fuming Aguero had to be held back by a group of people including City first team physio Lilley. Aguero tried to make his way off the DW Stadium pitch as Wigan fans celebrated their victory. The striker was clearly angry and chased after the fan before City coaching staff and Wigan man Dunkley intervened. Aguero was dragged away and restrained during the chaotic scenes which followed the full-time whistle. Mikel Arteta, right, also had to intervene and led Argentina striker Aguero off of the pitch following the incident. An advert seeing hoarding thrown from the section of City fans, which appeared to hit a police officer, is also under scrutiny, along with a pitch invasion that preceded that incident. Wigan will be asked to explain there were security arrangements, but the FA will wait until referee Anthony Taylor files his match report before judging whether to take action over the tunnel bust up between Pep Guardiola and Wigan boss Paul Cook. They will also use video evidence, with the incident caught on TV cameras. Fabian Delph's red card is not expected to be reviewed, with a midfielder left facing a three-match ban for violent conduct. Wigan chairman David Sharp denounced the actions of the supporters. "It's not nice to see," he said. "Football is emotional, it's what it does to fans. But I don't like to see this at the end of the game. It is a massive result, but we have to stay classy in football. I don't like what I'm seeing here," Wigan manager Cook added. "It's not right, it's not correct, player safety is paramount." The ugly scenes were reminiscent of those at Ashton Gate when Bristol City beat Manchester United in the Carabao Cup in December. City fans scrapped with stewards and police long after full-time, throwing objects including advertising hoardings having been goaded by home fans on the pitch. Battles with stewards continued after the players had left the field and the level of aggression appeared to intensify. A piece of the advertising hoardings is thrown in the direction of police at the DW Stadium after Wigan defeated City. A large number of police head across to attempt to dispel the crowd trouble after the final whistle. Fifth round tie had sparked into life when City's Delph was sent off for a reckless lunge at Max Power just before half-time. Guardiola and Cook came together in the DW Stadium tunnel, with Cook's assistant Peter Reid acting as peacemaker. Guardiola admitted Delph's red card was the correct decision by Taylor after the City man had gone through Power. And both managers tried to play down the flare-up on the touchline, even though Guardiola appeared incensed at the time by the behavior of the Wigan staff. Paul Cook is held back by Peter Reid as a group of coaches pull back. Manager Pep Guardiola. Wigan manager Cook appeared to be shouting at the Manchester City boss in the tunnel. Cook appeared to be furious at Guardiola after their touchline row continued at halftime. "You want to ask me about football? Ask me," Guardiola said. "Nothing happened in the tunnel. He, Cook, should stay in his position, that's all. They were a really aggressive opponent," Cook added. "We should just speak about the game. A lot is made of tackles. I thought straight red, Pep and his bench didn't. I stand by what I think and it was a massive factor in the game. The referee deemed it a red and that's what it is. I wasn't refereeing the game, I can assure you. Other people in the crowd deemed it a red card. The talk shouldn't be about stuff like that. Striker Will Grigg left scored a dramatic 79th minute winner as Wigan ended City's quadruple hopes, Wigan chief executive Jonathan Jackson said in a statement on Tuesday morning. Whilst we appreciate that the vast majority of supporters who ran onto the pitch did so spontaneously to celebrate a famous victory, we were disappointed with the action of a minority of supporters who acted in an inappropriate manner. Player and staff safety is of paramount importance and we will conduct a full investigation. However, it is important to not let the actions of a few supporters detract from an incredible night at the DW Stadium. A special atmosphere was created by both sets of supporters and the match was yet another memorable day in the history of Wigan Athletic.